Hi, I'm Amir Hussein Mirzabozorg, and in this video I want to talk about Abaqus warnings, how to interpret and resolve. How to ask your video related questions. Don't hesitate to ask any questions you might have about the explanations presented in this video using the comments below. We try to answer all questions regarding the video details in the comments below. This is the table of content. I will talk about Abaqus warnings, types of Abaqus warnings, warnings that you always receive at the beginning of the analysis, Abaqus model and its related publications, warnings that you always receive during the analysis, and finally, next tutorial content. When we submit a job, the simulation procedure starts. You might receive warnings in the job monitor dialog box during the simulation. Generally, warnings depend on the settings of the model in each of the Abaqus CAE modules or attached subroutines. This tutorial classifies these warnings and gives you deep insight into the procedure of encountering and troubleshooting them. Now I want to talk about Abaqus warnings. Generally, warnings depend on the settings of the simulation, including material definition, selected solver and steps, defined constraints and interactions, defined loads and boundary conditions, requested field and history outputs, mesh specifications like elements, quality and type, attached subroutines, and special settings such as the definition of ALE, crack, and others. There are two types of Abaqus warnings. Warnings that you always receive at the beginning of the analysis. Warnings that you always receive during the analysis. Now, I want to talk about warnings that you always receive at the beginning of the analysis. Even if all of your model settings are correct physically and technically, you may encounter this type of warning. There are two types of this warning. Warnings only aim to inform you about some rules and principles in the Abaqus. These warnings will not lead to convergence issues or any other types of problems for the simulation. So resolving these warnings is not essential and is not needed. Warnings that can lead to convergence issues or other types of problems for the simulation. These warnings can additionally lead to inaccurate results. Now I want to talk about Abaqus model and its related publications. I have conducted a simulation according to these two papers. To explain Abaqus warnings, warnings of the model related to these papers will be studied. In these papers, crack initiation in aluminium is investigated via XFEM in 3D space to investigate energy dissipation via acoustic emission. We have conducted this simulation in 2D space to simulate the crack propagation in the CT specimen. Now I want to show you these two papers. This is the first paper. And this is the second paper. Now I want to talk about warnings that you always receive at the beginning of the analysis. During the simulation, I have received these warnings. Now I want to talk about the first one. Whenever a translation or rotation DOF at a node is considered by a kinematic coupling definition, the translation or rotation DOFs for that node cannot be included in any other constraint, including MPCs, rigid bodies, etc. MPCs, external or internal, including those generated from rigid body definitions, kinematic couplings, and or equations will activate additional degrees of freedom. In this model, coupling constraint is defined in the interaction module. This warning will not lead to any problem in the simulation. In the 2D space, by default, nodes of triangular and quadrilateral elements do not have rotational degrees of freedom. If nodes are incorporated in coupling constraint, their rotational degrees of freedom will be activated. Now I want to talk about the second warning. A strain output request LE is not valid for some elements in this analysis. This request is switched to the strain measure E. In this simulation, due to the presence of small deformations, NLGM is not activated in the step module. So logarithmic strain cannot be requested and calculated. The engineering strain will be calculated instead. Now I want to show you the abacus model. This is the 2D model of the CT specimen. As the specimen is made of aluminium, I have defined elastic behavior, plastic behavior, and damage initiation and damage propagation behaviors for simulating the crack propagation via XFEM. I have used a static general step and the NLGM is set to off. I have defined XFEM crack and this is the initial crack. To apply displacement control loadings to the nodes around the holes, I have defined two reference points and I have defined coupling constraints between them and the nodes around the holes. I have defined displacement control loading to simulate the first fracture mode. And this is the mesh of the model. And these are the received warnings. And this is the result. Here you can see the path of crack propagation. This is the initial crack. Now I go back to the slides. Here I want to talk about warnings that you always receive during the analysis. Warnings that are given during the simulation give us some reports about the simulation procedure. They are more critical and some can lead to convergence issues. These warnings can lead to convergence errors, including too many attempts made for disincrement and time increment required is less than the minimum specified. If you encounter these warnings, do not kill the simulation immediately and wait for its progress. Now, I want to talk about these two warnings. The first one says, the strain increment has exceeded 50 times the strain to cause first yield at 3 points. And the second one says, the strain increment is so large that the program will not attempt the plasticity calculation at 2 points. Warnings can lead to convergence issues and may decrease the simulation speed. First, the definition of the plastic and damage behaviors must be checked. If consistent units were not used for defining these properties, these warnings may be seen. In the following tutorials, you will learn the procedure of resolving or encountering some important warnings of the abacus. You can contact me by using Telegram or WhatsApp, or you can send email to me. We can have one-on-one tutoring on the AnyDesk, WhatsApp, and we can make special tutorials to your order. We can conduct high-quality simulation for your thesis, exercises, and industrial projects. Now, I want to suggest you several related videos of our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a good time. Goodbye.